Sales del sad kingdom de pero I'm just in the point that I'm and see you on Monday. I'm not much nothing. So I can actually talk as loud as I want. And hopefully that works a bit. I have four topics, so it's gonna be a full blob. So first is Rojos. Rojos, well, Rojo is the word red in Spanish, but it's also a pad, it was on top of the pad, a bubble pack kind of thing. And yeah, I got it at home. It's quite comfortable. It makes bed sores and not a thing. Here they don't have it. So the nurses put pillows on me, tried to get me to turn one way or the other. But it's not perfect either. So I end up kind of trying to straighten myself up. And that's a problem too. I mean, the other factor that hospital beds have, they're too short for me. They're about 5 foot 8, maybe 6 feet. But I'm 6'4". My feet are right against the end. Even though I'm really pushed up in bed, and just started the tallest movement. And this could be called tallism. The tallest movement. Would fight for tall people's rights and stop tallism. Because really, it's painful trying to fit in a bed that's too short. It's really quite bad. Probably bend your spine a bit. Trying to figure that one out. Or just buy a new bed for them. Because at home I have a 4-inch extension on the bed. So I fit. But still, I still have to pull myself up. I grab the rope bar behind my head and pull a few inches. Most of that works. But man, when I came in, it was 2 weeks to do that. Anyway, the other thing is that TV over there is quite interesting watching. Corporate TV. I swear that ads are directed stretch their meats in my mouth. Or that's the thing where. I mean, that would be good. They actually figure how to advertise things here. And the advertisement I react to is BiPAP cleaner. It's a mask on my face every day. And if I had a good BiPAP cleaner, it would be good. And I don't know how they knew how to advertise that. But you them figure out. Maybe it's like Facebook or something. But I don't know. The one thing I saw on the corporate TV was the big fires in Alberta. In Edmonton area, above Edmonton, not quite Fort McMurray, but up above it, and some 5,000-acre fire. Not that big, but maybe it's 5,000 kilometers. Kind of the first of the year. This will be a bad fire year. It's been very dry. And that'll come back to you in fire season. But it was weird, the corporate TV. One from that directly to another story where they're trying to put a pipeline across BC from Alberta, and the BC government tried to block it, but they couldn't. So it kind of speaks to Canadian politics. It's a federal issue. They can decide, I guess. BC gets were run by Canadians. And Canadians says, yes, we want to sell oil. And I'd say leave the oil in the ground, but so much for that. Even though the third story I saw was about a huge protest, kind of going back to this Greta from Sweden, that little girl. My daughter was maybe at the protest. She went downtown on Friday to a protest. It's a weird one, though. Who protests against? Is it really the government or is it? The oil companies. That's the issue. Anyway, enough of that. On a more positive note, I want to talk about Elon Musk's big play and satellite, internet. It's huge. I mean, they got satellites up already. They have like 5 years more to go. But man, they're turning that on next year for Canada, the country I live in, which is really weird. I don't know how much it costs. Really good bandwidth. Super fast internet. From satellites. Not a bad thing. But Tesla's stock was way down. I don't know, it's under 200, I think. It was 350, and he was pointing, going to 420. But I'd say now probably below 200. But there's a $5,000 federal bonus, or what's called incentive, and then $5,000 provincial too, so $10,000 off you buy a electric car. That'd be good.